Hello everyone, welcome back to the Dockhands playthrough. Now, I was kind of split between going to the rest of Lothric Castle or the DLC, but I think we'll do Lothric Castle first. Because I think the DLC is harder. There's a chance that we might be able to get the level ups from the Black Hand NPCs, which will be useful. And there's one more Esther shard in the game to get, and it's of course at the top of the castle, so might be worth getting these things. Now, although I'm borrowing trouble here in a big way. Damn it. Gotta calm down here. Nope. Maybe I'll just have to punch him to death. Seems legit. Now, I'm going to apologize in advance, because there's probably going to be quite a bit of running through certain places. Not all of it, but as you can see, that particular little choke point is one of those places where I'm like, yeah, the bonfire is literally right there. Why not just go grab it? And then slowly work our way up from here. The other place I'll probably run past is... Well, there's actually two places in Lothric Castle. Actually, no, it's three, now that I think about it. Man, there are actually... There's a lot of, like, places that in this castle that encourage me to run a bit in order to get a shortcut or a bonfire. One before the Grand Archives, and two in the Grand Archives, specifically. And I don't normally like running past enemies as a way of playing this game, because it's a bit dull. You could run past everything in the game if you really wanted to, but it's not a very good gameplay. But on the other hand, there are places where the risk just isn't worth the reward. Depending on how hard the DLC turns out, I may have to respec my character to recover some of those wasted bigger points. Because in the end, I wanted to try and get a fast roll with the dark armor, but it's not going to happen. I don't have enough level ups in order to actually pull it off. Let's see if I can climb up here before he gets me. Yep. Not that I wanted to avoid him. I just thought it would be funny to dropkick him. Oh. I've been playing too much Dark Souls 1. I keep thinking I have a shield. I effectively do not have a shield here. Worst yet. The pace of combat is... faster than I'm realizing. Nah, I started playing some dumb Dark Souls 1 just because I can play that on my PC when I can't play this, because there are times when my PlayStation isn't available for one reason or another. Oh, I held the strong attack too long there. I'll get my groove back eventually. Oh crap, I shouldn't have stopped the drink there. Really should have done more of that to begin with. Oh well, there's one thing I'm good at, it's not putting my best foot forward when I pick up the game again. After putting it down for a little bit. But I definitely want to get this done before the Ring City, so let's keep at it. We're not doing too badly. We got plenty of Estus. Actually, here's another spot where I'm just like, why torture yourself over the enemies when you you can literally just push the bonfire here. I blocked it. In the sense of the word. Oh, you're alive. I invite you to stop being alive. Yeah, I don't see any reason to drag this area out. I don't need any of the upgrade materials. Or most of the items. But, you know. For the sake of completeness, there is a bunch of stuff I do want to do. But just not all of it. Like, I don't think I need to do the back air, the back alley area that has all the assassins. It's probably not necessary under the circumstances. Oop. Damn it. So annoying. I will simply spam you to death if you want to be that annoying. Who are you in life, huh? It's kind of rare to see a corpse around this area that has a head. Or do they all have heads and I'm not noticing it? No, they have heads here. Okay. It was just downstairs, I guess, where they don't have the heads. What exactly were they fighting here, anyway? They got barriers with, like, arrows in them and stuff. Which is kind of weird. I'm just going to refresh. And we'll start the process of getting around the castle. Do I do here again? Wait for him to help. Okay, that has a lot more range than I remember. It's supposed to drop down the side somewhere. I'm having trouble remembering. Like this? Yeah, that's it. That's how it's done. So I don't need to go that way. And I don't really need to pick up. Oh wait, there's an undead bone shard around here somewhere, isn't there? I should definitely get that, but, having trouble remembering all the details. Okay, I just got, the healer slapped out of me, but... I'm doing that badly. Maybe a little off my game, but seems to be okay. So I don't really need anything from around here for this playthrough. It's kind of hard to pass up killing the knight downstairs. Then again, even if I want to kill the knight downstairs, it may not be the best time to do it. Oh. Wow. That stung a bit. No, wait, of course I can't. That animation's funny. One of those places where I'm just like, it's kind of not worth the aggravation that you have to go through to fight all the enemies here in a patient way. Like, why bother? What you really want to do is just get to the switch. Oh, you caught me. What's the next step here? I actually forgot. I think it's running around to the elevator on the other side. gotta admit, I don't usually run past everybody in this situation, but today I'm feeling very... Oh. Bend the roll. Didn't make it though. You go down here, you go around here. We want to get in the elevator. Or at least we want to touch the elevator. There we go. Now that'll go down, and we are free and clear. That basically unlocks the Dragon Barracks as a place we can explore now. It's much easier to do these things backward. Now, I don't like this spot. I'm trying to remember all the little details about this area. Silver Cat? Where are you? There you are. I think, with a bit of care, we can drop down here. Yep. Really, just gonna let me punch it to death? I guess it is. I haven't actually done it in this order before. I usually take out the other dragon first. But today I just felt like going over this side quickly. It's quite an odd situation to be found myself in. I'm guessing the dragon will die, but the chaos thing, well, not chaos, the abyss spawn thing will remain alive. And I'll have to kill it separately. Looks bad. Is there anyone in here that I should be worried about? Probably not. Oh crap. I honestly don't know what I should do about that. Are you a mimic? Yeah, you are a mimic. Okay. I'm gonna deal with you first, because I know how to deal with you. Oh crap, I shouldn't have said that out loud. He's gonna kick my ass now. Don't spam that one attack. Oh dear. Feeling the pressure. Having said something unwise out loud. Now, unfortunately, with these guys, the Dark Hand is the absolute worst weapon I could possibly imagine to fight them with. And I don't really know any good way to, like, close in on them. Ow. No. And I guess I could leave it alone. It's not gonna hurt anyone. In that position. As long as the dragons are dead, I can do whatever I want otherwise. So let's gather up the materials. They don't really have much of a hitbox, huh? Can I walk through these? I can. Ooh, look at this. Woo! That's funny. It's not like the black blob things are necessarily that difficult, it's just the easy methods to get rid of them aren't available to me. Undead Bone Shard. That covers most things. Probably gonna die here. Ow. Amazingly, I'm still alive. The video decided to fork out of me really quick there. Okay, that's the end. It's alright though. The main thing is we got the undead bone shard. Let's burn that. And there we go. Now we have to teleport to the dancer's bonfire, I think. Then we can use the elevator to go back up, and we can continue on our merry way. Far more convenient, so what do you say? Let's just go for this first. Alright. I wonder if I can remember how to do this. Not doing too bad. That's a good start. Doesn't take a lot of damage, does he? And this is a problem. Because I'm not really good at fighting this guy for extended periods of time once he reaches about half health. I've always found the butterflies to be particularly annoying group of enemies to deal with. By himself, he hits really hard, but he's not too difficult to deal with. In aggregate. Nope. Okay, it's not. This guy was a nightmare at level 1, but particularly since I had crappy equipment at level 1, I did him as early as I possibly could. But he did hit me and it didn't hurt that much, all things considered. Damn it, I forgot that he does toothers. Oh well, this might just be a learning experience. We'll see what happens. I really hate this stupid turtling attitude he has right now. Oh! Man, how'd I end up on the other side of his shield? So this is... using up Estus at a rate which is not very helpful. Damn it. My stubby arms. Not helping matters. You miss me! This is gonna get hard when he starts actually, when they start shooting things onto the bridge. Because that's when your luck starts to come into play. Not your stat, unfortunately. Actually, it'd be funny if your luck stat actually, made the butterflies choose bad attacks to use. Like, hey, I'm lucky. Oh, hesitated. I thought it was a different kind of attack he was about to do. Damn it. Potion stiffness. Okay, get out of there. Do not want to be hit by that. I don't care so much about that. I'm gonna start putting my block up though, just in case I get hit by something stupid. From a direction I can't see. Oh, here's the audio cues. Okay, do something I can work with here. That's good enough. Oh, that kind of stuff is what I hate. Also, I can only kind of barely hear it because of how my microphone is set up. Much Estus. take enough dark damage. I don't think I can make this work. Not in one go. I have to be better at the first part to get more Estus. Oh, wow. I was still in range of that? Okay. That's a bit more like it. What are you gonna do? Ah, damn it. Wow, I just let him have me. Alright, another round. Let's do this. Damn it. Immediate failure. To get more than one hit in at times like this, but what am I to do? It's not cooperating. Damn it. I used to be able to read that really well. I'd know whether it was doing one hit or two or three. That was I'm gonna be able to win this fight if I keep wasting health on those simple combos. If he does one attack, I should just stop attacking. Because obviously I can't read it for crap. And my stubby arms. Ugh. Ah! Just so terrible at this. Why am I suddenly so bad? Maybe I was bad the whole time. No one told me. Ah, oh, crap. It's not the sort of attack you should really be hit with. I'm disappointed in myself because I used to be so good at this fight. Even under extreme duress, I was actually pretty good at this fight. I put all kinds of weird conditions on myself. Would actually do pretty fine with it. Ow! Literally letting him shield slam me in the face. I should have my shield up though. Even if it's a crappy shield, it would help against certain attacks. Again, I don't want to be hugging his damn shield. You gotta dodge in such a way that you're actually next to him when the attack ends. My attack has no range. If I'm too far away, I simply won't get any damage in. I don't have time to walk up to him between attacks. Alright. Didn't really want to use the Estus there, but what can I do? One of the few times I can attack with almost no hint of retaliation. And I want the bonus for my rings, so... Fireballs, huh? Nope. Jeez, it would be nice if you took damage from something like that, huh? Oh, come on. That's a good one. There we go. Nice damage. For a change, I can actually exploit my attack speed. Crap, fireballs. Fireballs everywhere. Oh, but we're doing this again, are we? Cool. Oh, nope. Not quite the one I wanted. Terrible. Do something useful. Can work with that. Gotta get out of here there. Ah! It's raining fire! Fire is bad. Oh yeah. Damn it. I prefer it when he does the follow-up attack to that though. Very easy to punish. Oh, damn it. He tricked me. Crap, I don't want to be here. Good. He chose an attack with a long animation there. This is more like it. I may not win, but I'm doing pretty well compared to my last couple of attempts. Crap. Although I blocked it, so didn't hurt that much. Oh, Fruit Loops. Kind of attack is just not on. Now I'm in a... Well, this is fair. Oh, stupid dragons. Whatever they are. We were having a good fight and you went and ruined it. Here we go again. That easy. Yeah, watch your move. Understake, huh? That sounds... Crap, laser. Laser scares me. Fireballs, because, you know, why not? Because it's one thing this guy needs, it's support fire. You know, I say that, but he actually does need the support fire. He's not that good a fight on his own. Having to control for these sort of factors though. I mean, they're relatively weak attacks in the grand scheme of things, but, it's when you do things like level 1 runs or low damage runs like this that suddenly it becomes a huge problem to have the control for these factors. Exploit anymore. Do one of the ones that are on the ground. There, that one. But then I need you to follow it up with the stupidly over-ambitious animation. Oh, crap. I hate that big firewall the most of all, because I can't seem to tell when it's coming, even with the audio cues. I don't know if it sounds different from the others, but I can't actually... I've never noticed it, if it does. And at soul level 1, that thing just murders you flat out. Oh, crap. Oh well, these are my last rites. Enough with the lasers. This guy. Are you gonna give me a chance here? Nope. I'm losing my composure. But of course I am. This is bullshit. Totally gonna, like, a fireball's gonna come out of nowhere and just eat me right now. Ugh! No weird cover fire? Are we done? Yes! Woo! Whew, okay. That'll do. Alright. Okay, I didn't mean to do that, but... it's all good. I shall see everyone on the next episode of the Dark Hands playthrough, where we will go back and cover some parts of the Dragon Barracks and proceed onward to the Crystal Archives, or whatever it's called. I've forgotten what it's called. Doesn't matter. See you then.